Welcome, outreach enthusiasts. My name is Joe Cerutti, and I am the program manager for outreach development for the Barbershop Harmony Society. We appreciate you taking the time to join us to update yourself on the progress of our grants process. It's been almost a year since we implemented a new and improved process and method for applying for outreach funds. And I'd like to take the opportunity to update you on the progress we've made in the last year, as well as provide some insight as to how you can apply for funding to impact your community in 2016. Let me share my screen with you. And we can talk a little bit about the objective of the program. The objective of the program is to build an awareness of the intrinsic value of singing, driven by barbershop advocates, providing inclusive opportunities to participate in the joy of harmony. And in doing so, we have four goals. One is to establish the Barbershop Harmony Society as a legitimate choral organization. The second, to inspire and develop lifelong singers. The third, to introduce and create an interest of barbershop to the general public through performance, collaboration, and marketing strategies. And the fourth, to affirmatively expand the Barbershop Harmony Society's community and culture beyond its current demographic core. So a little bit about the process. Prior to 2015, our focus was entirely on youth events, camps and workshops, one-day events, weekend events throughout the year. And as we decided to open the scope of our grants program, we have found that our chapters are hungry for all sorts of outreach to their community. Outreach to senior citizen groups, outreach to their local songwriters and arrangers, teaching the community to sing, collaborations with other high schools and colleges, and it's a really exciting time for us to be reaching out to our community. We have an opportunity to do that through the grants program with three different types of grants, and we'll talk about those in a second, but let's talk about the life cycle of the grant process for a moment. We have two different grant windows. The first one is opening shortly in September 1st through October 31st. And then we will close that to review for the month of November and December. And we will be sending out our decisions no later than January 1st. The second window is opening for February and March, closing for April and May. And the decisions will be made no later than June 1st. And both of these windows will be for, so the first window will be for any grant projects that are happening from January 1st, 2016 to January 1st, 2017. The second window will be for any project taking place June 1st, 2016 through June 1st, 2017. So that's a slight change for 2016, is that the both of the windows will be for one entire year for both of those windows. So let's take a minute to talk about the three different types of grants we have. We have the Direct Vision and Innovation Grant. The Direct and Vision grants are basically for the same sort of externally focused project or event. However, the direct grant is for projects that request less than $1,500, and the vision grant is for projects that request greater than $1,500, as long as the requested amount is not more than 80% of the entire project expense. The innovation grant, however, could be internally or externally focused, as long as the project positively affects one of the following outcomes: helping music educators improve the vitality and impact of their choral music program, helping young men become strong leaders in their schools, communities, and families, using a cappella singing as an effective positive intervention for key groups, including at-risk youth, veterans and wounded warriors and Alzheimer's patients, helping the Barbershop Harmony Society artistic and music directors improve their artistic and leadership skills, building capacity of Barbershop Harmony Society chapters to improve their outreach and recruiting efforts, and establishing singing as a core community asset. Again, with the innovation grant, it's important that the requested amount does not exceed 80% of the overall project expense. Each application will receive an extensive review. And I think it's really important to understand that we have a committee of approximately 20 professionals that have a background in either successful Barbershop Harmony Society leadership, experienced choral arts organization leadership, successful choral music education, or experienced grant writing and reviewing. So it is not required for the review team to have a background in the Barbershop Harmony Society. Many, I would say most of them, are not Barbershop Harmony Society members. So it's important to keep in mind as you're writing your application that it is very likely to be scored by someone who is not a member of our organization. Each application will be reviewed by three of those team members and scored on a 100-point scale, and each reviewer is encouraged to provide educational feedback as well. The application will then go through an executive review. The outreach grants team will review all of the scores and comments that were left by the committee, and if needed, the applicant will be contacted by us to clarify anything that we, any questions that we have about the application. And applications that require consultation with subject matter experts, or they happen to approach a cautious threshold of risk, will be reviewed by other BHS staff, including our CFO and CEO. Applications that are fortunate to receive an award will follow up with information that is, will receive a letter following up with information that it will be emailed to the applicant. The applicant will then complete the grant acceptance form, and if they are involving students under the age of 18, will be required to complete the youth protection training. All funds will be mailed to the awardee 30 days before their project is scheduled to occur, and we will expect you to do a post-event, post-project report that would be due 60 days after your project is complete. One of the things that I have not mentioned is that all of these reports, all of these forms, all of the applications are completed online through WiseHive, and you can find all of that information at barbershop.org/grants, and I'll repeat that site again at the end of the presentation. Applications that are declined will also receive an email with a summary explaining the reason for declining the project. Educational commentary from the reviewers will be included in that summary. And projects that we consider potentially successful will receive educational advice and be encouraged to resubmit in the second application window. So the application itself is open to not only Barbershop chapters and Barbershop Harmony Society districts, it's open to any nonprofit 501c3 organization. We have also opened it up to the community, not just youth events, encouraging projects of all ages and backgrounds and demographics. The application, as I said, is 100% online. All of the applying, all of the reporting is online through the BHS website. Each application will receive three reviews in addition to the executive review following that. The three different types of grants are available, and we have a dedicated staff this year to manage the year-round requirement. The reporting process, which used to be much simpler when we were only dealing with youth events, is now a little more extensive. We ask more about the demographics and the lessons learned the successes that you've gained, any stories that you have to share, more information about your project staff, recommendations for clinicians, teaching quartets, things along those lines. And of course, it's very, very helpful to receive thank you letters, pictures, and things like that that we are able to share with the very generous people, the very generous donors of the Harmony Foundation that are helping us to distribute the funds. So let's do a bit of a comparison. In 2014, we had 77 grants, 73 of which were awarded. In 2015, we almost doubled that number to 136 grants. And due to a limited amount of funds available, we were able to award 97 of those. So a major increase from 2014, which we're really excited about. In 2014, there were almost 12,000 participants that were anticipated, which ended up at the end of the year being 76, just over 7,600 participants. In 2015, the 97 applications that were awarded are anticipating to yield over 21,000 participants, which is incredibly exciting. So far, with the events that have taken place already, we have over 2,400 participants, and we're expecting to exceed 2014 by far over double that. So if you take a look at this graph, this is the number of applications that we awarded in 2015. You'll see that we have awarded to every single district except for the Ontario district. Right now, we are not able to provide funding outside of the country to any other countries, but we encourage anyone in Canada to contact Sing Canada Harmony for Canadian funding. If you look all the way to the right of the graph, you'll see that we awarded seven applications to nonprofit organizations, 501c3s, that are for the most part partnering with BHS chapters and districts to better impact their community. However, these numbers don't directly reflect the amount of funding that is being awarded to these districts. If we take a look here, you'll see that, again, every district is receiving funding except for the Ontario district, and we have those 501c3s as well that are receiving the funding. Just because you receive four grants doesn't mean that you get the same amount of funding as a district that's receiving 13 grants. It could be 13 direct grants at $1,500 versus four innovation grants at $8,000. Here are the 501c3 applications that were awarded. You'll see that three of them were Sweet Adeline's chapters that are partnering with local Barbershop Harmony Society chapters to reach their community. Three are educational institutions, one high school, two universities, and also one senior center, the Sweden Senior Association in New York. So here is the 2015 total at a glance of what we did. We received a request of $437,000 worth of outreach to our communities. We were able to award $267,000 in 2015, which means that over $130,000 were declined in 2015. All of those applications were provided educational support and what they needed to do to have a stronger application. And we expect them to come back stronger than ever in 2016. So we anticipate a fairly competitive round of applications in 2016. So again, we encourage you to make sure that that application is very, very thorough and very well written, because we expect to have more applications for outreach in our communities than we have ever had before. I think we all know that reaching out to our communities is changing lives. We do this not so that we can have more members in the Barbershop Harmony Society. We hope that that is a lagging indicator of all of the outreach that we do, all of the positive things that we do in our community. So our CEO, Marty Monson, has spoken for a while now about reaching out with no strings attached. And we know that the outreach that we do in our community is changing lives. It is affecting our communities in so many positive ways. And we don't necessarily do it so that they join our chapter, but we hope that if they have a great time down the road, they'll turn back to Barbershop at some point. So we expect to deliver some reports on the wonderful events that we have, that we are having in 2015, and share with you all of the positive things that we have going on across the nation. So we encourage you to consider applying for an outreach grant in 2016. That kickoff is happening September 1st. You can find all of the information at barbershop.org/grants. And we encourage you, if you have any questions or comments, or if there's any way we could help you, you contact us directly. Again, my name is Joe Cerutti, and we also have Ashley Turrell, who is helping with the outreach grants process. And you can reach both of us and the entire outreach team at barbershop.org. So I'd like to just thank you for joining us on this webinar. And if there is anything that we can do to help you out in the future when it comes to outreach in your communities, we welcome you to contact us. And we look forward to reading your application in September and October. Thanks so much for joining us on the webinar, and we look forward to receiving your application.